Solvite omnes. Today we're looking at feo. Okay, feo, which is an irregular verb, is actually the passive form of facio. Facio, when it's not a compound, just goes to feo for the passive voice. And so really it means be made or become. And you'll see it is irregular. It's kind of like a semi-deponent, for those people who know what that is. Semi-deponent, and so where the forms are in the active here, active forms, even though it's translated passively, in the active forms are the present, imperfect, and future, but then the perfect, pluperfect, future perfect, those are in the passive. So we have feo, and there's some forms that don't exist. Feo, fis, fit, femos, fitis, fiunt. Okay, and femos and fitis is not attested to. Okay, so I become, you become, he becomes, and then they become. A subjunctive here is fiam, fias, fiat. Okay, and then imperfect fieba, fiebas, fiebat, etc. I won't give you all the forms here, but it just keeps going. And then future be fiam, fias, fiat, so that'd be like I will become, or I will be made. Factus sum, I was made. So this is where it goes passive. And we'll just keep following the same pattern. Be factus est, facti sumus, etc. Factus eram would be the pluperfect. I had become, or I had been made. Factus ero, I will have been made. Subjunctives here are factus sim and factus esem. Okay, and the imperfect form is weird. It's fierarem, fierares, like that, and so forth. Okay, a couple other things that are not on here I'll add if you need to stop it and then go back. The big thing here is the imperatives. It's found usually in earlier writers, the grammarians say. So the earlier writers we have for the imperatives is fi and fite, become. Okay, that'd be the imperatives. Okay, and then we have our infinitives. Okay, infinitives would be fieri, to become. That's the present infinitive. To become. And then the perfect infinitive would be factus esse. Perfect. To have become. And then our perfect. Our future would be, future, which is not seen that much, would be factum ire. And then for the participles, of course, you just use the forms of facio. There's no PAP. PAP would, you don't use the PAP. They don't have PAP. They have a perfect passive participle, it'll just be factus. Okay, just like facio. And then the future perfect. The future passive or the gerundive would just be future passive participle would be this gerundive faciendis, which is just like facio. And there we go. All right. If you have any questions, just talk to me in class or send me an email. Valete omnes lingua latina esquita.